Clean waterways, it's the often repeated catch cry of the government right now. But downstream from political preaching is a 12-year-old girl called Lauren Greer.
And she might have found a simple way of helping the cause. Here's Michael Holland.
Before the real story, the light and the fluffy, we simply couldn't resist.
I love her so much because she's my baby. Good girl, come on. Good girl.
But come to think of it, how Lauren cares for two-week-old Gypsy is mirrored by how she feels about the river running near her rural home, west of Hamilton.
The Cunny Funny Far River. I was tubing down here with my friends and family and I saw the shocking amounts of rubbish that was on the sides and on just floating past and in the trees and everything. I was a bit cross, to be honest.
Enough to get her thinking, get her problem solving.
This is my invention, the rubbish tanifa.
The rubbish tanifa?
Yeah. The tanifa is a guardian of the waterways, so I thought that was a really cool name for it, since it's protecting our waterways.
We're going to put it to the test.
Yeah.
And it's going to work.
Yeah, it should do.
12-year-old Lauren's creation doubling as an entry in the Waikato Science Fair, where she cleaned up the Best Technology Award for students through to Year 13.
I can be useful. Tell me when.
The rubbish just comes down here with the current and it just gets washed in here. I also designed it so that eels or fish can't get hurt in it and they can just turn around and swim back out.
So what have you caught in here before?
I've caught the silage wrappings, the stuff that they wrap the bales in. I've caught aluminium cans, food wrappers, even a nappy, which is, yeah.
Yuck.
Yeah, gross what people leave behind.
Her biggest bugbear, though, those silage wrappings. That's her dad, Craig, retrieving some from downstream, while we set a couple adrift as a demo.
It's pretty much common sense. A bit like a sieve because it's really simple but it does work really, really well.
Some of the best ideas are the simple ones.
Yeah.
You don't always need bells and whistles.
No. He's trying to catch brown trout and that tells us that the river's pretty healthy except for the amount of rubbish that is in there.
She's proven to herself and to everybody else that age isn't a barrier to getting out there and doing something about our environment.
So what do you think?
I think it worked a treat, and I think you should do whatever you can to preserve that beautiful little waterway.
Yes, definitely.
The tanifa's done good.
It has. It's done everything I wanted it to. It was just a little way to make a big difference.
To call it GOAT, the greatest of all time, when it comes to her district science fair, might be a bit of a stretch. But given her other love, well, why not?
Oh, that is one cute goat.
That's very cool.
Lauren
is wonderful.
Amazing.
Isn't she amazing?
Just phenomenal. We have some wonderful young people in this country. I cannot believe that you're only 12 and you came up with that idea.
Yes, and wonderfully articulate too. And 2.8 kgs, apparently, Lauren pulls out of that particular stream every week. She goes and puts the net down from Friday,
yeah.
Picks it back up on Friday. 2.8 kgs.
Interesting too, she said most of the rubbish comes down the sides of the rivers. That's why it's sort of shaped the way it is. So one on each side, you'd be clearing a lot of stuff.
Yeah, good on you, Lauren.